Hi, I'm the Tabletop Teacher. In my unboxings, I usually talk about one figure per booster, but since the mighty Thor brick was so amazing, this means I skipped over a couple of rarer figures, so I thought I would showcase them in a quick video. Red Leader is the common prime figure in the Mighty Thor set, a fabulous sculpt, 50 points, 4 clicks, not a lot of clicks, but he has a trait that can bring him back to click number 1 when he's about to be knocked out. Betray the team again, or finally escape. For this thing to work, you need to have other characters with the Thunderbolts keyword on your team, preferably Indomitable or with Willpower. I would play Red Leader in a Thunderbolts themed team, just to be sure. Once per game, when Red Leader would be knocked out, you can give a Thunderbolts character on your team 2 action tokens, that's as long as it had none to start off with, and turn Red Leader back to click number 1. Cool, but is that a good deal? Well, he does have Outwit and Perplex in his special damage power, plus he can use Perplex as a power action to modify values by +2 or -2 instead of the usual +1 or -1. And a quasi-resurrection is always good, so yeah, a fun figure in any case. Makari has the Channel Cosmic Energy trait that other Eternal characters have in this set, which allows him to trade off his Power Cosmic team ability for Willpower and Perplex until your next turn. If he uses Perplex on himself, he can modify a combat value by +2, so that's nice. He has the Hypersonic Speed Probability Control combo I so love on his first 3 clicks, although he can only make close attacks with his Hypersonic Speed. Still, he has that with Precision Strike and Super Senses, Regeneration and Toughness on the last 2 clicks, but no stop click to make sure you get the opportunity to heal. 140 points is a lot, but remember that if he doesn't use his trait, he cannot be outwitted. 18 defense with Super Senses and Prob is hard to hit. I like. You know what? I'm also going to talk about Loki here. He's a common figure you want duplicates of. Yeah, I know, I keep finding good reasons to get myself more clicks. But here's why. Let's say you have 3 copies of Loki. When you build your force, you pay 75 points for him instead of 65, and you can add your other 2 copies of Loki to your force on this click. They are illusions. The combat values and powers are exactly what you see on his full dial starting click. Your opponent won't know which is which, and the illusions are not worth any points. Furthermore, Loki has shape change, and when he succeeds, you may generate another Loki illusion within range and line of fire. So even 4 or 5 copies of Loki are fun to have. Now if the main Loki falls to click number 3, a stop click by the way, the illusions vanish, they're knocked out, and Loki now has Outwit, Invulnerability, Penetrating Psychic Blast, and Sidestep. This is going to be so much fun to play. I need multiple copies of this one for sure. So that's it, just a quick add-on to the brick unboxing. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments below. By the way, know that I will be updating the key changes to the PAC and turn sequence videos. I made a mistake in one of them, and WizKids released an update on a couple of key issues. I want those videos to reflect that. Make sure to like this video, subscribe to the Tabletop Teacher, and thanks for unboxing with me.